Hello, ladies and gentlemen, I am back, and today we're going to be watching a Broken Alliances video again, as usual. This game is going to have me and Pope ally, and we're going to dominate. We're going to dominate some noobs. Pope really wants me to upload this, so I'm going to. And it's a pretty good game, so we had a really good run. Okay, now I'm gonna go to our. Immediately, I give him Melforth. Any minute now.
Research complete. Research complete.
Oh yeah, he gets the extra 300 mana for his bases, which basically gives him more manpower so that he can recruit more beefy units, if you will. Got some Magicania here. We chose to begin our adventure in the north. I'm going to be going for the sorcerer and then paler for centaurs. You might be thinking, why is my name causing Hetman? Well, because I like to smurf a lot. Smurfing means when you switch your name a lot, create different accounts, just to change the name of your account so you can go own some more people. That's basically what I do. I get bored with my old name, so I choose another one. Looks like Teal was late to get that item. So he's going to teleport north. Also begins his main here, close to our bases.
Our warriors have engaged the enemy.
We're going to be getting this item right here.
Our warriors have engaged.
I knew that this guy got caught. That was so bad.
Our warriors have engaged.
Damn, that sucks. I lose the first sorcerer for a dumb playa. I hope you can't hear it, but there's a vent in my room, so if you hear air moving, it's because of the vent. Hopefully you don't, though. I'm gonna be checking this replay as soon as I finish recording. Hopefully I don't hear that vent. Seems like Pink is going to be going for Lobelia right here. Wrath Ditties is going to be going for Grumgar. Oh, I love Grumgar. They finally made the Orc Savage medium armored. No, but they made the Giant Frost Wolf medium armored. Why don't they have like more variety? I don't think they have variety. They have medium armored units. Except for the basic spawn, which is unarmored. But that's bull. Oh, so this is what it is. You got marines here? I never knew this. That's crazy. That's what the prison key does. Nephrite Golem. Level 9. Holy crap. That's crazy. Anyways, so I regroup. I'm gonna probably increase the speed here.
Our forces are under attack.
Not bore you guys with the little battles here. Purple or poke flips on that hellmouth face. Takes out his hero. Oh man, this is funny.
Our forces are under attack.
He's taking on two people. I'm just racking up the XP for my hero. Got the centaur impalers, centaurs, everywhere centaurs. I finally decided to bring my mercenaries north. Forgetting this one wizard. He's just gonna be standing there with his pimp cane. Magical pimp cane. Because it has like a ball on top, it looks like a pimp cane, it's funny. Replace the ball with a diamond. You have a true pimp cane right there. Alright, so I'm going to be pushing red over here. But I realize that it's already under attack, so there really won't be any. Yeah, he's getting to me. Green.
Our forces are under attack.
He wants the book though. It has very good melee. I think it's called mountain training or something like that. Basically increases the melee speed attack every unit. And here I come in. With the centaurs. And then I rush out, and then I trap, and just try to get some speed here for my hero. Got a nice kill here for 11 gold. The bulk of the battle moves to the south west of the base. Ultimately, Pink runs away. He's like, oh shit, this is way too much for me to handle. Fucker came in behind me. Let's see where he's fretting. Oh. Blue. What?
Goddess,
blue. Brown. What? How? Oh, is it just blue and brown, right? I thought there was three players in that base. I was like, that's impossible. You can't have three way alliance. In Broken Alliance.
Our town is
under
attack.
It just doesn't work like that. It's not how this game was made. I thought it was like some kind of witchcraft for a second, but it was only two. Anyways, blue drops down that ward. I aim it with my two mercenaries, which die. And then, here comes the fun part. Some food for me. My centaurs were at the right place at the right time. I'm getting some XP here. Also gaining some gold. Gold very important. You want that gold as much as you can. I pull back as more of his units come in. The more of his units that came, the less it was worth to be there. Anyways, meanwhile, Light Blue is starting his own revolution in the middle. He has the Temple of the Tides. That's nice. I mean, I haven't played as that faction yet, but this is Frozen Throne, by the way, ladies and gentlemen. They moved from Reign of Chaos to Frozen Throne, and basically we have new factions available in the Frozen Throne. So he has Angler here. Looks like he has only Mordor spawns. Yeah, Mordor teams.
Our forces are under attack!
I try to create some movement here. In the end, I lose my hero. That was pretty careless of me.
Our forces are under attack.
But I swear I TP'd. I selected T, and then I clicked in my base right here. For some reason, it didn't happen. The TP did not happen, as you can see, right here. Basically, that's all for now. As you can see, yellow, he does exactly what I suspected him he did. He's just camping in his base. You can't camp and win. It's never gonna work. Let's see what green is up to. So green, pink, and blue? It's going to blue. Oh no, this is not working for him. Meanwhile, I'm poking at him over here with purple. So that's fun. Caught him in a bad position, really. I felt worse to start tearing shit up too. I'm gonna tell all these mercenaries to block off this entrance to the base right here. Look at that pro play right there. Pro. I'm a freaking pro. And I'm gonna tell all my range units to go over here and start defending on. Oh, and green chases me. Along with pink. That's hilarious. This is what really screws blue and brown over. Yeah, green and pink, they want to join the party. I still didn't use my healing room. So. Yeah, I book it out of there because I know that green and pink are just chasing hard. I do as much damage as I can and I leave immediately because this is not going to win against this. This is not going to happen. Pope bringing over his units, if he wants good. And then I'm also bringing my units over. There's a couple right here. I'm gonna be adding another Centaur Impaler into the spawn.
Our warriors.
Meanwhile, I'm just gonna loop around here, do a little loop-de-loop, and try to do something. Emphasis on the word. We got this bro. Most likely we didn't. Nope, it was green. So green gets it. Oh well. I dropped my ward right here. I try to block off the units escaping. There's a lot of fighting here. I get some kills here and there.
Our brethren's town.
Ultimately, green
attack.
Has a lot of money to spend. He has a lot of money to spend. But he has a Hardak, which is a Razor main base, so that's pretty cool.
Our brethren's town
Pink
is under
leaves,
attack.
Satisfied with
our
the
warriors
base
have engaged
burn.
Our sacred enemy. Grove is being desecrated.
Looks like Light Blue's running out of money, so he's just destroying all those towers. I mean, why not? A couple tens gold.
Our
make
town
a difference.
Is under siege.
Getting war. Oh, this is the camper. He literally goes for every single tower. Has a less than half design after destroying every single tower. Look, this Sasquatch is gonna run, then this Sasquatch is gonna run, then this one. Just leave it right to me, I start researching Spellmaster because of, you know it, Bloodlust. Get it to level 2, you're deadly as fuck. So once we get that,
our forces are under attack.
We will be superior in the magics.
Our town is under siege.
Let's get that magic.
Job's done.
I should just hold the Alt key instead of clicking on every single individual unit. That's probably annoying you guys if you can hear the click.
Our forces are under attack.
Let's check. Who else should we check out?
Our allied town is being attacked!
Okay, so he chooses to main Knocklock next, right after getting this space burned.
We're under attack!
Like Brown, like we are fighting in the south.
Our allies' town needs.
That's my base. Okay, cool.
Death
so he goes north. He also has, he has Dotar, and he gets 4 Fel Orc lightning throwers. We're both massing range, ultimately. That's pretty interesting. I just noticed that. We both massed range. Let's go see what Green is up to. Oh, yeah. He counters red. Ridiculously
counters.
Red's army is all medium armored. He notices that it's not gonna happen. Green's army and Pink's army are predominantly normal attacked. Well, they have a normal attack, which countered immediately. But Red also has Ogre Mount, so that's interesting. So this is a 4v1. Holy crap. Wow. He's getting 4v1. That really blows. You can be as good a player as you want, but you will never do well against 4 players hopping on the base. It's just
our town
never
is
works.
Under siege.
Oh yeah, Pope has a miscalculation here. That's really funny. I was looking at this. He's kind of cringing and kind of laughing at the same time. He gets all his huntresses and scouts trapped between werewolves. Funny. But I join him after burning Green's base right here, which I didn't show you.
Our forces are under attack.
But anyways, sadly, Red is eliminated. And he has no ally. Yeah, he chose to go solo.
Our forces are under attack.
So really, he dug himself a grave there, because... Yep. There you go. 4-on-1. Right there. That's what I was waiting for. Him.
Our town is under siege.
Those graves are nice. Two players here. Two players here. Dark Wind Runner, Strange King. The sound. Anyways, enough of with them. So, Purple and I, or Pope and I, are starting to invade Teal. I decide to attack his scout because I don't know what's going on. I don't really care if he sees me or not. I have two mines on me and 2-3 packs of healing wards on me. So it's about to be lit. It's going to be lit, fella. I'm going to drop an award soon. Aiming this tower, which is annoying. Caliber and we're all the same players and nerds. Enjoy the show. Level 2 Bloodlust, by the way. Gets fed, I get fed even more. 780 already. I start to go back because I get assaulted by Brown. And all hell just breaks loose. Look at all that food. Oh my god. 16. 16's everyone. It's about to be 12 though. It's nuts. Bloodlust makes a very big difference in the game. Get fed so much. Then I have to start researching everything. I give Purple some gold.
Our warriors have engaged the enemy.
Brown leaves because he just sees no hope. I prefer to go through here, so you can just aim down all the towers here, and they won't be on the right. Entering through here. It's just my preference. I'd rather face two towers at once, that instead of one, two, maybe three. But yeah, technically I'm facing two. I don't know, I just feel more comfortable in microing when I face the towers through this entrance. This is all food, of course. And we go to Pink. He's just chilling here. Oh no, he's campaigning in the south of the map with Green. Looks like he's going to be assaulting Orange, who has the puppy and Master Warrior. It's one of my favorite bases, even though it's not as good as my base in this game. It's still one of my favorite bases. Man, the speed at which the health decreases is just amazing. Let's go see what he's up to. Irishman? I've seen him before, but he's one of the newer players, I think. Unless it's a smurf, like I am here in this game in this case. Oh, he left too. Okay. He's really not in here. Blue.
Attack.
Blue still hasn't given up. Pretty noble. But Sir Anakin looks like he's double maining. He's unsuccessfully maining himself. Volcanus and well, that's what happens when you camp. You have a level 3 hero while Blue has level 11. But that might not be fair because we kind of attacked Blue continuously.
Our forces are under attack.
So we did give him another opportunity. But still, you should never camp. This doesn't justify it. Nothing justifies camping. Camping sucks. Eagle Eye. Increases the range of all ranged units by 50. Helps me and it helps him as well. His is 525. I've already upgraded mine, so it's 575. 575. I think I already upgraded the research center one as well.
Job's done.
Nobody quested for the sludge beast, which is funny. So purple starts to switch in. Yellow's trying to. Oh, okay. So that's his hero spawn. No, but he has a spawn here as well. Looks like he's trying to main in three places. This guy's crazy. You don't main in three bases, dude. Unless it's like very late game. And I'm just running around the map. Trying to get somewhere. You see the downfall of yellow right now. Yeah, he's just gonna get killed. This is level 1 bloodlust because we did not have a chance to research level 2. None of his bases have the book for increasing the level of magic stone. Unlike mine did here, if you recall, yellow started. I go to light blue. And this is where the fun begins.
Our forces are under attack!
He sees me with all these mobile artillery. I'm surrounded by something blue, which would be the smartest thing to do. But you know, bloodlusted centaurs never a good idea to run away from because it's a challenge for them. And they accept all challenges. He will charge you until you are unconscious. It's just not a good idea to run. Take out these title lords without any trouble. Even this coward dies in under 2 seconds. Here, make myself comfortable, start taking out all the problems, start taking on his hero. He tries to come in with some dwarven monsters, which are peasants with centaurs. They basically get trampled. Soldiers, taskmasters. know he tries to attack me with his mortal thing. Except my units are not lightly armored, so they're not gonna feel any of his mortals. It's like a mere skill. Okay. So then the centaurs will charge in here. Start firing up this base. Fire everything. Good. And this will not be the last time this evening. That's for sure. He tries his little ultimate again. Chances of, I think. I don't know why he's gonna do this. This misplaced the time. He uses his magic jammer on my centaurs, but not gonna work. I still have my brilliance aura of centaur, which is basically my captain. There he is. Right there. This is from my first commission item. So it's pretty much the oldest unit that I have from all the spots in this game. And I take out this base, start working on this base. The situation is just hopeless for him. He does not know what to do. He starts pinging to his ally to come and assist him. Wow, he really...
Our town is under attack!
Why didn't he reinforce this? I don't understand. Could have easily reinforced it, but he didn't. So that's his loss. Orange is pinging here. He's like, no, dude, come attack over here. We have suspicious activity here. Basically, I take out his base. Yada yada. Holy light, my center. I can heal. That ultimate didn't even target the bulk of my army. I only targeted my hero, that was so impressive. Such a bad cast of an ultimate. It's horrible. Oh, and then here comes his ally to the rescue after it's already been burned. So I have 1.1k gold. Orange is like, fuck that shit, I'm not going in there. God knows what these centaur will do. I'm so proud that I have this guy still. Usually my commander dies in like under 2 minutes after being commissioned. Because I would always get into these little fights for items, like over here. Where was that one place? Over here, where the guy, where Red acquired Nephrite golems, I think. Yeah. And I'm gonna increase the speed a little bit.
Let's see if
he has any battles going on here. Oh yeah, Pink. I almost forgot. Pink is still alive. No upgrades. What? I only have one upgrade though, so I can't really say anything. But they're on their way.
Meanwhile,
I come to help. He did research a magic upgrade, which Nachlock has. Yeah, Nachlock. I should have captured this. Wow. No matter, I mean, I still won. Spoiler alert. Still won, but it would have been a lot faster if I acquire this upgrade for the map. Light blue questions. Triple on taunt.
We're under attack.
And I say no such thing in Benson's Broken Alliances. I love slow motion battles. creep up on light blue and orange here. Orange starts reinforcing, which is a good thing. Meanwhile, we're just destroying everything in his way. Not a good time. His upgrades are 3-1, mine are 2-1. About to be 2-2. I didn't start making anything in this base because, you know, whatever. Didn't really have to. Since when did he have level 2 bloodlust? I don't know. Oh, it's because my units gave him bloodlust. Okay. That makes sense.
Our warriors have engaged the enemy.
Oh, this is probably where I'm going to be fucking up. Bloodlust going on. You know someone's gonna die. Let's go see.
We're under attack!
Alright, so this is where pink and orange do the hard work for me. So really, this game is all about timing. Meanwhile, purple.
Our ally town is being attacked.
I'm just creeping up on this battle. I was like, oh, look at all this money fighting. Look at all this food.
Our ally town is being attacked.
Look at all this food fit for a king.
Work complete.
And so, with that,
forces are under attack.
I join the fray. So 3-2, we have 3-2. Where is his hunter's home? I can never find out where it is. So he only has one hunter's home. 2-1. I dropped some arrows, dropped some judgment. Some pretty good against the weak range units. This is just an area I found. That's good. Good for that. My hero dying. Psych. He has an off of wound enemies. She'll be alive again. And here. That is some David Blaine shit right there. I remember this.
Our forces are under attack.
He leaves as soon as his hero dies, and his hero gets in so quick. That was so funny. All you see is the Beastmaster coming up on India, dropping everything. Oh, to 100 real quick. So then Green decides to fight us and realizes, holy shit, we're not useful. Especially against the 3-3. And Bloodlust. You're never gonna do anything against Vile with 3-3 upwards and Bloodlust plus level 2. It's never. You're never gonna destroy it. All his units die before they can even reach him. They get like one or two hits on us. Hope gets all cocky. He's like, GG. Noobs, get on my fucking level. This is funny. Anyways. Well, to be fair, we have 3-3. It's just the bloodlust really carried him. I'll be honest. I'm gonna lose a potent sorcerer right there. Oh well.
Our forces are under attack!
Then we decide to go south. Or do we decide to go north? Well, I just scout out that this base is gone. So he buys a base. Okay, cool. Yeah, he buys another base. I just keep researching, research. 4-4. Coming up. As you can remember, this was Red's base.
Our forces are under attack!
Meanwhile, Green is preparing with Pink for an assault. And he does rightfully so. They didn't even share units. What? The heck? Oh no, it was only Green who didn't share units.
Summoning is complete.
Our allies' town needs help. Our warriors have engaged.
So yeah, we start destroying these trees. Uncover the space a little bit. Give us some more angular advantage. Even his ships don't want to engage with us. Because they know they're in for a real good looking. This is just an epic battle. Between pigmen, centaurs, elves. Let's see how it looks like from their perspective. Oh my god, that's... That's a pretty ominous sight.
GG, man.
Take this off. Kreef has left the game voluntarily.
Our warriors have engaged the enemy.
My old enemy Pink and I finally set a conclusion. And I aim his juggernaut because they do splash damage and it's just really broken. 100.198 damage. Very creative too. These Goblin Juggernauts have the sole purpose of them in this game is to just destroy massive units really. As you can see, they're pretty successful. until he gets them.
Our forces are under attack!
Which just means we're too powerful. There's a shield generator. So I can't put his own thing. They're all dead of it. Blade Master has a crazy attack speed. My hero does like 2 attacks per second. And I just keep feeding purple. He doesn't even need the feed. But I kept feeding him anyways. Getting attack range level 6. He's doing the same. So now it's just us and Orange. I'm gonna speed it up a little bit.
We're under attack!
He does some
research complete.
Exploration.
Our town is under attack.
Okay. So here comes the end.
We're under attack!
I'm gonna kill these a lot of guys. Cause I hear a lot of Sentinels dying.
Our forces are under attack!
Towards the end, you really don't feel like my brother. It's when in the beginning that you might win. Cause that's when you... when losing a unit really hurts you. Being down. Just another unit.
Our forces are under attack!
See the stream of centaurs just marching down. I like that. It's nice. It's very, very cool. So Blitz. Once you can live long. Oh, he plants a mine, of course. Oh, that's cool. I do the same thing. It's the magic thing. Who gets 2 hit? That's it. Our units are always powerful at this point. Not even mine is the game. As you can see, GG. Top score he reckons. Well, yeah, dude, because I fed you a lot of money. Yeah, I fed him a ridiculous amount of money. And clearly he did his own work too. He's killed a lot of bases, but I feel like I made more money than he did. Because of the bloodlust. That's really the sole reason why. Because of the bloodlust. Yeah, all my units were stuck here for some reason because it's like the mountain terrain.
Our forces are under attack.
Told them, what the hell? Yeah, they do that as well, which is annoying. But no matter, I just took them out with just the Centaurs. I took them out with half my arm, really. Half my arm. Intended arm. Then I said, you know what? Let's not use any more Centaurs. Let's just put them all in 8. At this point, it's GG. GGW. Pope and Cossack win. So he's produced more units, and he's also killed more units. I produced a little bit less, but I killed more than I produced. Thank you for watching. If you've enjoyed, leave a like, subscribe for more, and I will see you guys next time.